Progress OpenEdge enables you to make your OpenEdge application available as a REST service that can be accessed by any REST client. In this video, we'll expose a sample ABL application called Customer Order App as a REST service. Customer Order App has a customer.class file that contains five methods that perform CRUD operations on the customer table. Create, read one that returns a single customer record, read all that returns a list of all customers, update one, and delete one. To make Customer Order App available as a REST service, we need to annotate ABL resources, map REST operations to ABL operations, and then test the REST service using a REST client. We start by annotating the customer.class file. In the Project Explorer view, we right-click the customer.class file and select Progress OpenEdge, Define Service Interface. The Define Service Interface wizard opens. Here we select REST from the Definition Mode drop-down list. In the Workspace Resources section, we scroll down to view the customer.class file and select it. Notice that five methods of the customer class are listed in the ABL Routines section. We select all five methods and then click Next. The Edit Annotation page appears. Notice that both REST Main and REST Detail annotations are displayed. We click Finish. In the Project Explorer view, notice that REST Content and Pass OE Content folders are created. We scroll down to Defined Services and expand the node to view the available services. Notice that the REST service, Customer Order App Service, is created. In addition, if we open the customer.class file, we can see that the REST annotations have been added. The next task is to map REST operations to ABL operations. To do this, we first add REST resources to the defined REST service. Then, for each resource, map REST verbs to operations in our annotated ABL class file. And finally, for each REST verb, map the HTTP request and response parameters to the interface parameters. We start by adding a REST resource. To do this, we open Customer Order App Service in the REST Resource URI editor. We click the plus icon in the Resources section. The new REST Resource dialog box appears. Assume that when we planned our REST service, we came up with the URI names we wanted to use to identify our REST resources, customers, and customer/custom ID. We add our two resource URI names to the Resource section. We are now ready to map REST verbs to ABL operations. First, we select the customer's resource. Then, from the Verb Association section, we select the Get Verb. The Associate Operation with Verb dialog box opens. We select the customer class file. When we select a class, the ABL methods of that class appear under the ABL Routines section. We select Read All and click OK. Next, we associate the POST verb in Customers with the Create method. We repeat these steps to associate REST verbs with ABL operations for customers/custom ID. We associate Get with Read 1, Put with Update 1, and Delete with Delete 1. Next, we map sections of the REST request to ABL input parameters and sections of the REST response to ABL output parameters. We start by selecting the customer's resource. When we select a resource, the verbs associated with that resource are displayed in the Verb Association section. When we select the Get verb, notice that input and output tabs are displayed in the Mapping Definition section. Also, notice that the Input tab contains a request box with three sections and a parameters box with an interface parameters section. To create a mapping rule for input, we click a section under the request box and drag it to make a line to the required interface parameter in the parameters box. In this case, for the Get verb, we select Complete URL under Request and then drag a line to URI under Interface Parameters. Notice that a connection is established. Similarly, we create a connection from Query String Parameters under Request to num under the interface parameters. To create a mapping rule for output, we click the Output tab. Notice that the Output tab contains a parameters box and a response box. Here we select TT All Customers and drag a line to the body section in the response box. Similarly, we create mapping rules for the remaining REST verbs for our two REST resources, customers and customers/custID. We are now ready to test our REST service. Before we can test it, we need to publish it. Publishing a REST service involves exporting the REST application package from Developer Studio and deploying the REST application package to a web server. In this example, we will deploy the REST service to OEPass 1, the default instance of Pacific Application Server for OpenEdge, or PaaS for OpenEdge, that is installed with Developer Studio. We start by exporting the REST application package. To do this, we right-click Customer Order App Service in the Project Explorer view. Next, in the context menu, we select Export Services Incrementally. The Export REST Application window opens. We select Pacific Application Server for OpenEdge as the server type and ensure that the Export Services Incrementally option is selected. In the Destination field, we specify the location to save the REST application package. It is recommended that we save the REST application package in the Web Apps folder of the PaaS for OpenEdge instance. We navigate to the folder and click Save. Next, we click Finish. To deploy the REST application package, we use the Deploy REST command line utility. To do this, we open a ProENV window and then navigate to the location of the REST application package. Next, we enter the Deploy REST command. The Customer Order app is now deployed on the PaaS for OpenEdge instance. Using OpenEdge Explorer, we restart OEPass 1 for the changes to take effect. After the REST web application is deployed, we can test it using a REST client. In this example, we use Advanced REST Client in the Google Chrome web browser. First, let's try to retrieve a list of all customers from the customer table. This task is performed by the read-all operation of the customer's resource. To access this operation, we enter a URI that specifies the application location, the REST service, and the REST resource. In the header section of the client interface, we specify JSON as the messaging format. With GET selected, we click Send. The URI returns all the customer records from the customer table. Now let's test adding a customer record to the customer table. We use the same URI. We select the Post option, enter customer details in the Payload section of the REST client, and then click Send. In the response, we can see that a customer record has been created, and a custNum value has been generated by the application. Finally, let's test the customer's custID resource by retrieving one customer record. To do this, we enter a URI specifying the custID value. We select GET and then click Send. The record of the customer is returned in the response. Similarly, we can test the delete and update operations. We have now successfully exposed our OpenEdge applications as a REST service and tested it with a REST client. To learn more about making an OpenEdge application available as a REST service, take the Providing Progress OpenEdge Applications as REST Web Applications course.